My father was a part-time DJ in the 70s, and the good thing about that was that I was able to hear a lot of 70s style funk and all that type of music. So I used to listen to a lot of Parliament and Sly Stone and all the James Brown, all the funk stuff. But because my father was just so good at what he did, I didn't want to do that because I was like, there's no way I could do something like that. So I was more quiet, and he's very extroverted. So I went to school for chemical engineering, and while I was in undergraduate school, I started doing music as a hobby. Once I went to graduate school at Berkeley, that's when I really decided that I wanted to pursue my musical passion instead of chemical engineering, because I just knew it wasn't meant for me. My heart just wasn't in it. And so in the beginning, I decided that I just wanted to be a producer and not necessarily a DJ. So I figured I would just produce the music and get the vocalists out there. So that fate would have it, I ended up performing, and then from performing to DJing. So it's like really good for me. In the beginning of my musical career, I came up with my name Kashmir because my middle initials are CAJ for Curtis Allen Jones. And then I added the Mir, became Kashmir. And in the beginning, I was doing a lot of house stuff. So when I decided I wanted to do a bit more techno stuff, instead of confusing the house fans, I decided to come up with another name. I came up with Green Velvet. So the major aliases I have are Kashmir and Green Velvet. And then I have a whole slew of other ones, but I don't do them so much. So when I first started my own record label, my first single was Brighter Days with Daje, and that was a really good song for me. It was one of the songs that I wrote to help make one of my friends feel better. So it just ended up doing really well. And also at that time, even before Brighter Days, there was a song called Percolator. They first came out in 92 and really started doing well in 93. And at the end of 93 is when I came up with Green Velvet. So I think like Brighter Days, Percolator, Shake and Pop, La La Land, Preacher Man, Destination Unknown, Flash. Yeah, Flash. Those are some of the more popular songs that I've done. Video, so I was like, well, I want to do a video no matter how, you know, of course within the budget. So I've always done low budget videos because I never had a big budget for them. So I've been fortunate in that I've had some really creative video directors and people like that who've made some very interesting videos. And one of the videos a lot of my fans like, it's like the La La Land video, it's very, very interesting. I'm going down to La La Land. I hope to see you soon in La La Land. And Shake and Pop is really popular too. Hey, Mr. DJ, let the beat play. Turn up the stereo. Up some more, so I can flex what I got on the dance floor. And the recent one I've put out is for Percolator, because I re-released that this year, and that's doing really well. It's time for the Percolator. 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 I have are Casual Records and Relief Records. Casual Records I formed in 92 to support a lot of the house artists in Chicago, and then later I started Relief Records in 93. Sometimes I put out more stuff, I do stuff with more artists, and sometimes I don't. It just depends on the mood and what's going on with the artist. I've still been doing stuff with Daje. The last song I did with her was Say You Will, which did really well. And I'm working on a new song with her entitled You Can. And I'm doing tons of remixes. I just did a remix for Felix Cartel for his song Love. I've done a remix for Carte Blanc for their track Gare du Nord on Ed Banger. And I have another song coming out called Let Go with the Japanese pop stars. And a whole bunch of other projects. I got a new album out. It's time. And it's more of a collective of my older material as well as some new stuff.